We estimate about 400,000 Australians each year diagnosed and treated for common skin cancers. We have about 16,000 people with melanomas. It's billions of dollars that we spend every year, and it's really a staggering burden in this part of the world. We are in the southern hemisphere, and our country is located fairly close to the equator. That means there's a lot of solar radiation hitting the Earth's surface each day. 90% of our population lives on the coastline or close by. So it's a cultural thing, it's a lifestyle thing, it's a solar system thing, it's an aerosol and atmospheric thing. And then there's our population, which historically has been populated by people from Northern Europe who have the worst kind of skin possible for living in this environment. But Australia has pretty good regulations now in terms of the way sunscreen is tested and labelled and manufactured. We have really good regulations in childcare settings and early education for shade. We have good regulations in workplaces now. Even adopting full prevention, it's going to be hard to get to zero skin cancers, but you know, gee, we can go a long way. We know we can go a long way because 70 and 80 years ago, we didn't have a skin cancer problem because people wore long sleeves, they wore hats. So we can maintain our lifestyle, but change our behaviors, and hopefully the rates will go down again. So I'm an optimist, but I think it's going to take a while.
What I want to see is that there's a foundational piece, which is just whatever you're doing outside, doesn't matter if it's for physical activity, learning, nature play, community garden, your standard practice is, oh, you're outside, it's sun safe first. This isn't something that you can regulate like tobacco, because UV has that element of, you know, the vitamin D part of it. There's a lot of great things about being outside, so we have to find that balance of how do we have everyone live the life they want to live, but have that sun safety idea in the back of their mind as being a core part of, oh, I better think of this while I'm doing something else.
The main thing really is to not take our foot off the accelerator, so that all of these good behaviours become the norm, that the bad behaviours are seen as bad behaviours. We're at a sort of pivot point, and if we persist with the momentum and keep pushing forward, then I'm really hopeful that we can have a great future in Australia and actually lead the world in the prevention of skin cancer and be a success story that everyone wants to know about.